Hi friends, welcome to this online lecture series on polarography. As you know, polarography comes under the topic of electrochemistry. Polarography is a very versatile technique which has been used in the analytical chemistry to determine both qualitatively and also quantitatively the ions, organic materials in a test solution. In this lecture series, there will be introduction. There will be derivation of the Ilkovic equation. There will be some aspects of the polarographic wave equation, advantages and disadvantages of polarography. So, dear students, let us go to the introduction part of the polarography. The first topic will be on history of polarography. So, the very speciality of the polarography is the use of the dropping mercury electrode, which was invented by Jaroslav Hajrovsky. This dropping mercury electrode has a very special type of character. What is that character? It can renew its surface continuously. In any experiment involving an electrode, the problem what the scientist is facing is that after a particular time, the electrode, the surface of the electrode will get deposited with some other materials, or it may erode, losing its original activity which was there in the beginning. Dropping mercury electrode removes all these difficulties. So in 1922, it was Jaroslav Hajrovsky who invented the dropping mercury electrode, and he received the Nobel Prize in chemistry in 1959. When we search for the history of polarography, it can be seen that Jaroslav Hajrovsky was a very good science student, and at the very young age, he was so passionate about the subject, and he told that I will become a Nobel laureate. And in his Nobel Prize talk, Jaroslav Hajrovsky has told that the reason why I keep some 38 years to the electrochemical researchers with dropping mercury electrode is its exquisite property as electrode material. Here we will see how he was very passionate about using the mercury, the only liquid metal, as an electrode. And it gave him strict reproducibility, and also the equations can be expressed mathematically. As I mentioned, it was William Ramsay who gave all the initiative, or meaning to say, Hajrovsky was so passionate about, actually he was listening the Nobel lecture of William Ramsay, and then and there he decided that I will, one day I will become a Nobel laureate. So it was William Ramsay, as you know, he is the inventor of the noble gases. Or he discovered the noble gases, and he was a very iconic man in science that time. Although we know that Hajrovsky has done the polarographic experiment with the dropping mercury electrode, it was not Hajrovsky who first used the dropping mercury electrode. It was C.F. Varley and Gabriel Lippmann. These two scientists from the Russian school, and also from the Yugoslav school, what they were doing is that they wanted to measure for some other properties, and they firstly they used the dropping mercury electrode. That means the idea that a liquid metal can be used as an electrode was not new at the time when Jaroslav Hajrovsky determined or invented the polarographic method to determine the concentration of ions. It was C.F. Varley and Gabriel Lippmann. Later on, it was Bohumil Kusera who extensively used the electrode for measuring surface tension. Actually, this scientist Kusera was the guide of our Hajrovsky. The history says that Hajrovsky was serving in the army during the First World War, and once he returned, he was going to defend the his PhD thesis. At that time, Kusera was one of the examiners there, and he asked some questions on dropping mercury electrode. Kucera was trying to use dropping mercury electrode to measure the surface tension of the liquid mercury and also some other materials. So Hrabowski was as a very good student. He answered all the questions which were given by Kucera, and Kucera was so impressed, and he asked Hrabowski to join immediately in his laboratory. And from there he started working on the dropping mercury electrode. Actually, his idea was not to measure the current voltage curves, but his idea was to measure the surface tension. And on 10th February 1922, he did his first measurement, the IV curve. What you see in the diagram is the first IV curve plotted by Jaroslav Hrabowski in 1922. So what he observed was that he applied a constant potential of 2 volt, and he saw that the current increased drastically after above 0.5 volts. And later, Dr. Masuzo Shikata from Japan, he came to, after hearing his discovery, he came to Jaroslav Hrabowski, and they associated together. He made a very important other discovery together. Actually, when Jaroslav Hrabowski was measuring the current voltage curve, what he was doing is, he wanted to know the rate of the dropping mercury electrode, which we will discuss little bit later. He had to weigh the mercury, and he had to count the number of drops of mercury falling from the dropping mercury electrode, and then he will have to weigh the mercury and then again work again. So that was a very tough task. And when Shikata came to Yugoslavia and started working with Hrabowski, he invented another machine, and in which automatically the current and voltage curve could be measured. That was a very stunning discovery, and from there onwards the determination of polarography started. As you know, those days there was no any spectroscopic measurements, so scientists relied heavily on the polarography to determine unknown metals in an analyte solution. But all those works were only in an empirical state. He did an Hrabowski could determine that, or he could establish that there is a direct relationship between the current observed, the diffusion current observed, and also on the concentration, a direct dependence between concentration and the diffusion current. But a theoretical value, a scientific explanation was given by Dionys Ilkovic, another Russian scientist, in 1933. That is 11 years after Hrabowski invented the dropping mercury electrode and the first measurement of the current voltage curve. It was Ilkovic who gave the correct explanation for the observation made by Jaroslav Hrabowski. So that is the history of polarography. In our next lecture, we will go to the derivation of the Ilkovic equation and other parts. Thank you.